Oh, at the moment for relapsed refractory CLL, we have a lot of options because we have still, of course, chemoimmunotherapeutic options, bendamustine plus rituximab, or other treatment that have not been applied in first line. But in particular, now we have many novel drugs, chemo-free treatment, so ibrutinib, idelalisib plus rituximab, and venetoclax, either as monotherapy or in combination with rituximab. The rationale to use another BTK inhibitor is that we still need molecules that are better tolerated, because the BTK inhibition is a very effective treatment for patients with relapsed refractory CLL, but it has to be taken continuously, so the patients are exposed to the possibility of adverse events. So we need effective therapies, but also better tolerated, and acalabrutinib could be one of these options. The ASCEND study is a phase 3 multicenter international study comparing in patients with relapsed refractory CLL either monotherapy acalabrutinib or physician choice that has been was between bendamustine plus rituximab or idelalisib plus rituximab. So a well-established immunochemotherapy or a novel combination of drugs. The acalabrutinib, the novel BTK inhibitors, is now currently studied in a head-to-head comparison with the approved BTK inhibitor ibrutinib, and so we will know if and how there is a difference in efficacy, in particular in tolerability of the drug. Another study has been recently concluded where acalabrutinib alone or in combination with obinutuzumab was compared to chlorambucil plus obinutuzumab as a first-line treatment in elderly patients with chronic lymphocytic leukemia. The study has been concluded, a press release has been made indicating that the primary endpoints were reached, so we expect to see the results very soon.